G'day guys, I'm pretty pumped about this one. I got this one for my birthday. I've got to say, it was very unexpected, but this kit is absolutely awesome. If you haven't seen this sort of on the net yet, it goes with one of the 1/9 German motorbike sidecars, and there are a couple of versions of this, I think, that are out at the moment. I'll pop them up on the screen for you. I have bought before from ModelCellar, another German 1/9 figure, and the casting on that was fantastic. But the sculpting on this thing, when I looked at it, I just thought, this is a kit I have to have. Very, very few and far between that you're going to pick up a 1/9 scale kit like this sitting on a German motorbike. Really hoping that someone brings out another one for the Kettenhund. But this thing here, and the dog as well, the German Shepherd. I mean, come on, guys, this is exciting. Obviously, I think you can also get the 1/9 scale bike or something similar on its own, and you could obviously just have the figure on the bike on its own as well. Obviously, I opened this up before, and I can tell you this is an absolute ball buster of a kit. I mean, holy meatballs. Have a look at this. Look at the packing on this little fella here. I mean, seriously, guys. Lovely piece of foam, and look at this. This is how I picked it up. Look at that. Look at these little peanuts all around the outside, and another piece of foam underneath. Absolutely lovely packaging from ModelCellar. Didn't mention the sculptor, Kaz. And Kaz, I'm not even going to pronounce your last name, but you can read it there. I'm not going to do you any injustices by me trying to pronounce that. Just some details on the side there. But I can tell you this kit, as soon as I started putting it together, it reminded me of the PMC miniatures kit by John Rosengrant and I think Chris Crossgrove. Sorry, Chris, I always think I pronounce your name wrong, which I definitely probably do. So I apologize for that. John Rosengrant, how good is he? G'day, John. Now, look at this kit. This kit, I picked up two pieces on this kit right from the start. I picked up this little fella here. And this little fella here. And the first thing I noticed were these two little fellas here. Now, on some dodgy kits, these things you've got to chop off, and because they're just sort of added there for annoyance, basically, or, you know, paw marks, whatever. These two little fellas here, this fits straight into here, and this is magic, guys. Watch this. Straight in, like that. But look at the back. Look at the back there. Isn't that nice? Even there's hardly even a line there. Absolutely fantastic. Even when I did that, I look over here and there's another two holes and I'm like, no, no, can't be. So then I pick up this little fella and here we go. We've got another two little pieces here. And look at this. And these little pieces go in there like that. Look at that. Awesome. And then you start to roam around the kit and look, you see another little hole. And then you see another little hole, and then another little hole, and you go, surely not. And then you look underneath and go, no way. So you look on the side here, and you go, well, I'm just going to try this out. And you kind of think, it's not going to fit, you know, because most resin kits, they're not absolutely perfect and stuff. So I've got this little fella here, and I basically just put him in and went, no. No way. Look at that. Straight in. Got the holes. Straight in. Look at that at the back there. Unbelievable. Absolutely love this kit. And I thought when Kaz sculpted this, because I don't think he sculpted too many figures, apologies if you have, Kaz, I thought, oh yeah, this figure will be okay, but this is a ball buster of a figure. Absolutely. If you're thinking about getting this figure and you haven't got it, don't be a crazy chicken. Seriously, go and buy it, because there's nothing more annoying when you're thinking about a kit that you want to buy and you don't buy it. And then, you know, 6 months down the track or a year down the track, wherever it is, you think, oh, I'm going to get this kit. And you know what? It's gone. It's gone. Sorry about that. I had a postman turn up and he had a funny parcel for me. And he keeps on bringing me these parcels. I don't know why, but... And I open them up and there's always a model inside them. It's just crazy, guys. Just crazy. Anyway, so, as I was saying, I was sort of... as far as I know, I don't know if he sculpted that many figures. And so I thought, oh, well, I might change the head because I've got a couple of Rosengrant's heads. And apologies, Kaz. I've got a couple of John Rosencrantz heads, you know, the Warriors ones and stuff like that. I might swap this head over if it's no good. And then when I started looking at this head, I thought, holy dooly, magicabooly, this is a really nice head sculpt. And I thought, well, as much as I love John Rosencrantz, I don't need to change this head. This head is fantastic. Look at it. Look at it. Absolutely lovely. I can't rate this little figure high enough. Absolutely, just the quality of the casting. ModelCellar. Love your work. And just the detail and all the little bits and bobs you get in between. You even get the little square on top of his head here to fit the helmet in. So we're just going to do that. Why not? It's ready. Guys, look at that. I do love a kit that just goes together. I don't mind gluing, and I love painting, but I don't like sanding resin much and cutting it with a little saw, one of my pet hates. So when you can get a figure that just goes together like this, and look at this. I mean, why can't other resin figure companies do this? I mean, seriously, it's just John Rosencrantz and Chris. PMC Miniatures did it a long time ago. Even S&T Miniatures. There's a Jim Sullivan and John Rosencrantz. They were doing stuff like this a long time ago as well. They're the kit manufacturers that I loved. I mean, seriously. Jeff Hsu, I love you, but take notice of this sort of thing. Love it. Andre Miniatures, with your 3D printed stuff or whatever you're doing now, take a little bit of notice and stop doing that weapon in metal. Can't stand it. Just do a decent resin one. Now, I'm going to show you another piece. Why? Because I can. So I grab a leg and I look at the holes and go, normally these are going to have to, some of them are going to have to get chopped off. I'll show you this again because it's magic. Look at this. What? What? Is this two parts or one part? It's one part. No, it's two. Now it's one. I can't believe it's not butter. It's unbelievable. Look at this. Seriously. Look at the creases and the folds. Alpine Miniatures. No, it's not. But I'll tell you what, it feels like an Alpine Miniatures, just a little bit bigger. Absolutely beautiful sculpting. Now, in saying that, then you pick up the little woof woof. Now look at this guy. I mean, seriously, I've got a dog. And my dog is not as good looking as this dog. This dog is awesome. You've got little teeth in the side here. Can I show you the teeth? There you go. Just the teeth on the side and the ears. And one thing I'll say about this as well is the casting. Every time you sort of get something like this, the ears are broken off. But here, no, they're not. They're not broken off. And the chain around the neck. Heavens to Betsy. Absolutely beautiful. Look at that. Look at the fur and the pattern that's on it. Even down the bottom there. Near the rude parts. Absolutely fantastic. And you know what? I thought, this is unbelievable. And then I realised that they had the seat for the motorbike, the sidecar seat. And then I thought, surely not. So I put this down here like this and go, you, I don't believe it. They've even padded in for the dog to sit in. Even the dog. It's a little bit more work, you know, to sit him in there. A little bit more padding, but, you know, we're talking about they've done this for the actual seat. They didn't have to give you the seat, but they have. And on that, if that's not enough, they also give you the two little bags to go on the side. At the back of the motorbike. Here. That's what I'm talking about. Focus, damn you. Here. Look at these little fellas. Goodness me. Goodness me. Look at that. Even the detail on this. What else can I show you? I'm not going to pull this bag apart. Why? Because I don't need to. You've seen the detail on this stuff. The machine gun has the handle already in his hand. Look at that. I do like that. I've mentioned that 100 times on my videos. Look at that, that's packed. They've even got that packed in a little bag with another little staple, and the other one was packed in a bag with another little staple. If that's not enough, look at the detail on this. Look at the detail on this thing. Come on, little fella. Look at that. goodness me. Don't know if this is the one that fits in here, but again, you've got the little hole. Look at the little texturing on this where they've already pressed it in. We'll see if it's this one. Look at that. Look at that. No. Look at that. They've even got this little bit here that sort of goes in between there. Jesus. This is beautiful. I was really umming and ahhing about this kit for a long time. And I was hassling someone else about it, who ended up buying it for me for my birthday. Look at that. There is one other thing I want to show you. Well, two things, actually. Let's try the head. Let's pop the head in here. Again, you've got your little pluggy thing there, and his head's in. Voila. Just like that. And then the other thing, and adding to that, you actually get, do you get one helmet? No, you don't. You don't get one helmet. You get two. Two for the price of one. Well, you probably actually paid for the two, but anyway. But look at this. This one is if you just want to paint it and paint the lens like this on the glasses. And this one is if you actually want to pour maybe a little bit of resin in there and you make your own glasses. Or if you want to put a bit of clear plastic over the top, it's up to you. It's up to you. It's totally up to you. What would I do? I don't know. But you get another helmet for another figure. That's pretty good. Or you could have another helmet sitting on the back of the bike or wherever you want. Absolutely fantastic. They didn't have to do this, guys, but they did. They did do it. A couple other little pieces. Again, absolutely lovely casting on these things. Did I mention you get two of these? Two of these? Guys, I've got to tell you right now, if you're on the fence about this kit and you're thinking, should I get it or should I go and buy another kit? Don't. Because you'll regret it. Get this. Don't worry about the other kit. It's going to be around for a fair while. This might not be. Absolute crack of a kit. You put this in a model show, this is what people are going to be looking at. It's just a thing of beauty. Absolutely love it. Kaz, model seller. Is it Paul? I think it might be Paul. You two, absolute crack of a job. Love your work. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later.